So, in order to address this question, while addressing this question, we will come across this concept of equilibrium concentration of vacancies or equilibrium number of vacancies in a crystal lattice. So, why do crystals create vacancies? The creation of vacancies or point defects in crystals is due to the competition between the energy minimization and the probability. We will see what you mean by what probability are we talking about. This competition is what creates the vacancies. So, when you are creating a vacancy, there is an energy associated with this vacancy creation, which is called vacancy formation energy. Okay. So, for instance, let us assume that the crystal, the given crystal for which we are actually trying to understand whether there are going to be any vacancies or not under equilibrium. Let us assume that the crystal is in equilibrium with vacuum. Okay. Then what happens? If you want to relocate an atom from one of its lattice sites, from the bulk. So, what do you need to do if you want to relocate? You need to break the bonds and then move the atom from the bulk to the surface, right? And hence there is an energy associated with that. So, the relocation of atom from its lattice site to external site surface creates a local distortion in the crystal lattice, because suddenly this one atom is missing, you have broken the bonds, suddenly one atom is missing and these atoms find freedom to deform because there is no constraint here. And as a result, the local movement of these atoms creates distortion in the crystal structure, and that is going to increase the internal energy of the system. And that energy associated with moving an atom from its crystalline site to the surface where it is not having any interactions with other atoms, the energy associated with that is called vacancy formation. So, this vacancy formation energy is a property of the material. For every material, you will have some vacancy formation energy because it depends on the bond strength of this material, right? And we know that the complete segregation of atoms and vacuum is not possible. So, you cannot have the vacuum because you are saying that atoms and vacuum are in equilibrium, right? You cannot segregate them. So, now the competition between the vacancy formation energy and the probability, what probability we will talk about in a minute, determines the equilibrium vacancy concentration. And this is the expression, NV is number of vacancies in a crystal lattice, where N equal to number of lattice sites. EF is your vacancy formation energy, T is the temperature in absolute temperature in Kelvin, and K is the Boltzmann's constant. Okay. So, we need to derive this equation. So, now let us assume there are NV number of vacancies and NA number of atoms in your crystal lattice. So, there are total NA plus NV number of lattice positions available. Out of all these lattice positions, there are NA number of sites are occupied by atoms and NV number of sites are not occupied by atoms. So, NV number of vacancies, NA number of atoms are there. And we assume that, or in general, the number of vacancies should be much smaller than the number of atom sites, right? Otherwise, everything will be nothing. Right, if you have very few atoms and then you cannot call this as a material, you rather call it as atoms as a defects. Not everything is free space, right? That is important. So, NV over NA should be much less than 1. That is the assumption. So, if you have NV vacancies, so whenever you remove one atom from the crystal lattice, from the bulk and take it out, then the vacancy formation energy is EF. That is what, that is the amount of energy by which the internal energy of the system increases whenever you remove an atom. So, if you have NV atom, NV vacancies, so the total internal energy of the crystal would have been NV times EF, right? The base internal energy, if you make it 0, right? So, the total energy would be now NV times EF, because each vacancy is created by providing an vacancy formation energy of EF. Is that clear? Okay. Of course, EF must be positive. If it is negative, what happens? The you keep on forming vacancies, and then eventually you will not have anything. You will have only nothing. You will have only vacuum. Okay. So the crystals allow vacancies to increase the entropy of a perfect crystal. Entropy. Entropy is nothing but what? Entropy is nothing but a measure of disorder of the system, right? So the crystals allow the formation of vacancies because it will increase the entropy, right? Perfect crystal will have. A perfect crystal is perfectly ordered, so there is no entropy. The entropy is zero there, right? So we have this expression for entropy: S equal to S is your entropy, K log W, natural log, where K is your Boltzmann's constant. What is your W? W is the number of ways we can arrange NV vacancies in NV plus NA atom size. Total number of Actually, I should have said lattice sets, right? Total number of lattice sets. There are only NA positions occupied by atoms, and NV plus NA are the total positions available. So, W tells you the number of ways that we can arrange the number of NV vacancies in this total number of NA, NV plus NA sites, or I will also call N equal to NV plus NA, total number of N sites. Right, so that probability can be written as NV plus NA factorial by NV factorial NA factorial, right? And now we know how to define free energy of your system. Free energy H, Helmholtz free energy, is equal to internal energy minus absolute temperature times entropy, right? Now when you want to seek equilibrium in the presence of vacancies, then what you need to do, you need to find the stationary value of this Helmholtz free energy, that is dH over dNV must be equated to 0, right? That is the condition that we need to employ in order to find equilibrium in the presence of vacancies, right? So this is Boltzmann, and this the concept of this entropy as a disorder was put forward by Boltzmann. I think you must have studied this in your thermodynamics class, right? Yes or no? All right. So log W is equal to, so S is equal to, what did we write? K ln W, right? Natural log W. Ln or log E are same. That is, and W we have written NV plus NA factorial divided by NV factorial times NA factorial, right? So that is, I am replacing, I am substituting for W here. This is log A by B, that can be written as log A minus log B, right? So it can actually be written as log NV plus NA. So let me write down, can be written as natural log NV plus NA factorial minus natural log NV factorial minus natural log NA factorial, right? And now if you would plot log natural log X factorial and X log X minus X. For very large values of X, they both are same. Here they are not the same, but for large values of X, they are the same. And hence, I can approximate log X factorial as X log X minus X for large values of X. And we know that NV and NA, we are actually talking about number of atom sites and vacancies. They are usually going to be much larger than that, right? And hence, this makes a reasonable sense. This approximation, Stirling's approximation, makes a reasonable sense. And hence, I can write S equal to K log W, and then if I employ this, and then in this, if I plug in that, then you will get this expression. Right? Once you have your S, and you have H is equal to U minus TS, and substitute U equal to EF minus NV, right? And then T is your temperature, absolute temperature, as we have written K log W. And then you find the derivative of H with respect to NV and equate it to 0, and then you will get this expression. NV by NA plus NV e power minus EF by KT. So you can write NV equal to NA plus NV, I am calling N. So I can write NA e to the power minus EF by KT. So this will tell you the equilibrium concentration of vacancies in a material, where if you know the vacancy formation energy of the material, you will be able to calculate how many number of vacancies should be there at a given temperature, because this depends on the temperature, right? As you increase the temperature, what happens? As you increase the temperature, what happens? As you increase the temperature, this can be written as N by E power something. As you increase the temperature, this quantity, entire quantity will decrease. As a result, NV will increase. That's what we have discussed, right? You can create vacancies by thermal activation. Nicely described by this simple formula, right? So let us try to calculate the number of vacancies in a material, okay? So the formula is number of vacancies, equilibrium concentration of vacancies equal to N times e power minus EF by KT. What is the Boltzmann constant? I don't remember. 1.38 into 10 power minus 23 joule per atom Kelvin, or 8.60 into 10 power minus 5 electron volt per atom Kelvin, right? Please note down that part and then try to calculate that. So we are trying to calculate the number of vacancies in a copper crystal at 1000 degrees Celsius, at very high temperature. And at 1000 degrees Celsius, the energy of vacancy formation is given to be 0.9 electron volt per atom. The atomic weight and density for copper at the above temperature is 63.5 gram per mole, 84.8.4 gram per centimeter. Okay? We want to try this. First of all, you should know how many in a perfect crystal, how many at lattice sites are going to be there, right? That N, we don't know N, right? Can you calculate N? You can, right? You know the atomic weight, and of course you know the density as well as the volume, cubic meter of copper. If you have a cubic meter of copper, and if you know Avogadro's number, and then you can actually plug that in. So the number of atomic sites is Na, that is Avogadro's number, rho is the density, right, divided by atomic weight of copper in the consistent units, and you find that to be 8 into 10 power 28 atoms per cubic meter. We are asked to find per cubic meter, right? So in 1 cubic meter of copper, you will have 8 into 10 power 28 atoms. How many vacancies will be there at 1000 degrees Celsius? So you just have to plug in. You are given EF, you know K, and you know T, and you know N. Then plug in. How many vacancies are there? 2.2 into 10 power 25. So there are vacancies everywhere, right? That is because it's almost close to, what is the melting temperature of copper? So you please go back and check why there are so many vacancies. What will be the number of vacancies at room temperature? let's say 30 degrees Celsius. Can you calculate quickly using this formula? Is the density going to change as a function of temperature? The density of a material changes as a function of temperature or not? But we don't have the information, so use the same information as density, and then just for the sake of understanding, can you tell me how many vacancies will be there if your temperature is 30 degrees Celsius? The room temperature in Chennai is little higher, right?
T equal to 303 Kelvin. So say 8.6 into 10 power
significantly reduced, right? 10 power 25 to 10 power 13 vacancies. So the temperature plays a significant role in creating the number of vacancies. If you would calculate the percentage of vacancies here and percentage of vacancies with respect to the number of atom size, you will realize that. So even at room temperature, you will have some vacancies. When will you have zero vacancies? Absolute zero. And now, can you see why you cannot have a perfect crystal? Right? Your thermodynamics prohibits you to go to absolute zero. So you cannot, no matter what you do, you cannot bring a material to zero Kelvin, and hence you cannot have a material without few point defects, right? You will always have some few number of point defects. And as you increase the temperature, the point defects, the number of points, so the concentration of vacancies keeps on increasing in a material. Okay? All right.